All right, let us continue with the concept open source licenses. So we were discussing about open source yesterday. Licenses as concerned with open source, they provide you certain benefits. Okay, like, let me mute all the participants. As you can freely use the software, you can freely modify it, you can freely distribute it. So license provides you certain benefits. Okay, you can avail some benefits. And what are those benefits? Suppose you are making any project, sit properly in the class. You are making any project. You can take help of others. Other people can contribute in your work. And for this, you don't have to take any prior permission. You can take help of others. Other persons, they can help you. They can contribute to you in your work. And for availing this facility, you no need to have, you don't have to take permission. Okay, clear? Then suppose you have created some work. You are the original creator of the work. So certain rights are provided to you. Clear? Vivan and Rian, if not interested in the lecture, then you can leave the class. Leave your PC work and pay attention to the LCD. All of you just look at the LCD. Then if you have created some work, license ensure that you get the due honor for your work, due reward for your work. Okay, your work should be recognized. And last but not the least, you are the creator. You are the original creator of your work. Other people should not put a claim that work has been done by them, not by you. Suppose this child writes any essay. This girl should not claim that the essay is not written by her. Instead, it is written by me. Right? The work of original creator should remain of original creator only. Moving to the next slide. Now we start with the licenses. Our first license is GNU GPL license, Journal Public License. Now it is the most common type of license, very popularly used, and it provides variety of rights. So many rights the GPL license provide to the users. You can freely distribute the software. Okay, you can share the software, you can copy, you can modify, no fees is charged for it. You are not bound by any restrictions. You can make as many modifications as you want. Okay. Then is lesser GPL. Now, lesser GPL, as name explains itself, it provides less rights as compared to the normal GPL. The rights provided are less in number as compared to original GPL license. Suppose you want to have license for the free software. If you are obtaining the license for the free software, your free software can be incorporated as free plus proprietary. It will have both the features of free as well as proprietary. Okay, clear? The third one is BSD license. BSD stands for Berkeley Software Distribution. Berkeley Software Distribution License. Now, actually, it is a family of permissive licenses. Permissive journal meaning is free. Free from any restrictions. Like I say, this group of students has very permissive nature. like they are very free in nature. Okay, one who doesn't pay attention to anything, one who is totally free on itself, that is called permissive. So such licenses, they are not bound by any restrictions. They are totally free type, right? Very few restrictions are imposed on the BSD license. BSD license in turn is of two types: new BSD license or modified BSD license. Now here, two options are there. I told you that when in open source, you get the source code. The source code can be available in two ways: either original source code as it is, either in the binary form. When you get the source code in the binary form, then you get the encrypted copy of it. You have to change it into original. Okay, either you get original as it is, either you get the binary form. Right? So whether you get in original or whether you get in binary form, some conditions you have to check. What are those conditions? The first condition, suppose you are redistributing the source code. If you are redistributing the original source code, then you have to keep the original copyright notice, original terms and conditions, and a disclaimer. In general sense, I have a question from you. What do you understand by disclaimer? According to you, what is the meaning of disclaimer? Beta, please focus on the LCD. What is disclaimer? Many times on the numbering of the when numbering is going for a movie or anything, disclaimer is written there. Suppose I have created this document and I give this document to you. Later at the bottom, I disclaim it. I mentioned that if it contains any error, if it contains any condition or any clause, I am not liable for it. Kisi cheez se aap deny kar dete. You don't take responsibility for that. Like I have given it and I say that if it contains any error, I am not liable, I am not responsible for it. This is called disclaim. Okay. So if you are redistributing the original source code, you have to retain the original copyright, the set of conditions, and a disclaimer. But if you are distributing the source code in binary form, right, then you have to reproduce the copyright, the fresh copy of the copyright, the fresh list of conditions, and disclaimer, right? So two conditions are there. What is the third condition that you are to check? Suppose you are endorsing the work. You are promoting the work. You are promoting the product, or you are endorsing something. Endorsing means handing over something to someone. You cannot use the copyright holder name and the contributor name without their permission. Like I have the copyright. I am the owner. If you are distributing my product, you cannot take my name without my permission. You cannot mention my name over there without my permission, without my consent. Right? So if these three conditions are met, you can avail the benefits of new BSD license. Clear? Then is simplified BSD license. In the simplified, madam, please, my class is going on. In the simplified BSD license, normally all the rights are same as the new BSD license. but only there is no clause for the endorsement. Like in the new BS license, the third condition was for the endorsement. Here there is no such a point of endorsement. Okay. The next license is Massachusetts Institute of Technology license, MIT. MIT stands for Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Now, the rights covered under this license, it is totally permissive, very loose as compared to GPL and BSD. Right? Some rights are similar to the GPL rights. You can easily copy the software. You can share the software. You can modify the software. No restriction on the distribution. But only one restriction is there. It is bound by the license agreement. You are to enter into an agreement. Okay, that condition is there. Rest, all the rights are same as the GPL rights. Right? The last one is Apache license. Now, Apache license grants some rights to the user. First, rights are perpetual. Perpetual means ek aisi cheez jo lagatar chalti rahi. A thing which continues to run forever. Perpetual means one thing which goes on forever, which doesn't stop, which continues. Rights are worldwide. It doesn't take into consideration any key is country mein rights hain or is mein rights nahi hain. You are in any part of the country, can you please sit straight in the class? If not comfortable, you can leave. It's not hard and fast that it's avail the rights in one country and not in other. They are prevailing worldwide, all over the world. No fees is charged, no royalty, nothing. Rights are non-exclusive. Aisa nahi hai ki is in rights mein ye wala area include hai aur ye wala area exclude hai. Some persons are included and some persons are excluded. It covers every group of person without any discrimination. Rights are irrevocable. Irrevocable means a thing which cannot be revoked, cannot be changed. Clear? So when you get a short note on Apache license, cover all these 5 points. All these 5 rights that together cover your Apache license. Okay? So these are your license GPL, lesser GPL, BSD, Massachusetts, and Apache. Total 5 licenses are there. Is PPT visible clearly? Yes, just a minute. Now the concept is freedom of information. Suppose there is any government website and some information has been uploaded for the citizens of the country. Okay. Koi important information upload hui hai. So being a citizen of India, you have full right to read that information. To access that information, it is not hard and fast rule that only for limited number of persons that information is available and only particular set of group of persons can read that information. The information is globally available and it is available to every person. Every individual, every person. Lakshya, please focus here on LCD. You are continuously working on your PC. Demonstration is going here, bete. So every person, every individual has the right to access the information, that information which is published in the social media platforms or the public platforms. What is the purpose of that? To make things transparent. What I say when I say things are transparent? What do you mean by this term transparent? Clear. Everything must be clear. Rules must be transparent to everyone, must be clear to everyone. Okay, government accountability. If I give example of school, students are accountable to teacher, teacher accountable to principal, principal accountable to management. A chain is there. So we have to give proof. We are totally accountable to the government. We should disclose all our facts to the government. Our picture should be clear. We should not hide anything. Right? General public protection against mismanagement and corruption. If any individual or any citizen having any problem, might be any corruption problem or might be anything wrong being done. Okay. Full protection must be provided to that citizen. Public must be aware about the rules and public must be given protection against any wrong practices done. People must be aware of it. And if anything wrong happens, full protection measures must be adopted to safeguard the interest of individuals. Clear? Next is digital divide. Rehan, sit straight. To understand the digital divide, I give one live example to you. Suppose this group is rural area. This group is urban area. Rural sector, urban sector. Resources here are limited. Less, very less. Okay, here there are bulk of resources. All the technological resources are fully available. Here very limited, either nil resources, either limited. So difference comes. यहां पे बिल्कुल नहीं है और अगर है तो बहुत कम है. यहां पर फुली ऑप्टिमम यूज ऑफ रिसोर्सेज है. एवरी फैसिलिटी इज प्रोवाइडेड इन दिस सेक्टर. सो हु इज एट रिस्क? रूरल सेक्टर. हु इज एंजॉइंग? द अर्बन सेक्टर. नाउ टेकिंग दिस लाइव एग्जांपल, इमेजिन द इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी, द टेक्नोलॉजिकल फैसिलिटीज आर either nil or less in rural area, but they are fully available in the urban area. This is digital divide. The gap or the division between the persons who have access to internet and technologies and those who do not have access to technologies. Or if they are having, they are having limited access, right? This gap, this division is digital divide. So another definition of digital divide can be the gap which exists between individuals who can access modern technologies and those persons who cannot, right? Clear? Now, why, what are the reasons, what are the factors of occurrence of digital divide? First and the foremost factor is the division between the rural and the urban areas. Discrimination between persons on the basis of income and their education level, socio-economic differences. And third one is difference between the availability of internet. In rural area, internet facilities are very less, but in urban areas, the facilities are more. So these three are the important factors for which give rise to digital divide. Okay. Now, there is an important note for you. It can come as MCQ. The Right to Information Act was passed by Parliament on 11th May 2005 and it came into effect on 12th October 2005, replacing the FOI Act of 2002. So when was IT right of IT Act was passed? 11th May 2005. And it came into effect on 12th October 2005. Okay? Freedom of information. Freedom of information. All right. Digital unity. Again, the same example. One sector of society, second sector of society. Resources should be equitably distributed. There should be no discrimination. Equal division of resources must be there. Equal use of technology must be there. All the modern technology facilities must be equally used by all the sectors of society. If they are getting internet facility, you should also avail that facility. You should also be having all the resources which are required. This is digital unity. Then only we can say our society is fully balanced. Our resources are maximum utilized. There is equal distribution between the rural and the urban sector. There is no discrimination involved. Clear? Am I clear? So 10th class, with this, I end up the board syllabus of term 1. Right? I once again run the entire PPT. If you have any queries, you can discuss.